make of the idea of wealth redistribution? If today someone was to say, I am going to survey the wealth of Prakash Raj, I'm going to survey the wealth of X, Y, and Z, and equally distribute it to everyone in this country. In principle, do you think it is feasible or practical?
It is not practical, it is not feasible. It cannot be a law. It is an idea. It is an idea of empowering all people. Please read that speech clearly. It is an idea that we need to look into, give them equal opportunities. It is not taking money from you and giving. It is not that. But with this government, there is no redistribution. The minute they know somebody has money, there will be an ED raid and they will take the money. That's how they have taken with bonds. That is what they have taken. Whoever doesn't give are inside the jail. Who have given are in the washing machine and they are very pure. Now, when a prime minister talks about eradicating whatever this money laundering is, what is he doing? 60% of people in the party are the rogues from the other parties only, no? How did they become pure? And he is making a joke of a parliament. India has 500 plus parliamentarians who have to represent their states, their problem, the aspirations of their constituency. But he wants somebody who will only talk about him. They have candidates like a candidate who will say the first prime minister is Subhash Chandra Bose. What will she talk about the future of this country, of the laws of this country? Somebody who played Ram many years back is suddenly a candidate and we all go and ask them, what will you do in politics? I will learn on the way. Is it something to learn on the way? Are you making joke? Mera muh dekhe vote karo. No. That is not the constitution. That is not the spirit of democracy. Is he going to then, bring
all these people, all these people have fought elections earlier as well. Arun Govil has earlier campaigned for the Congress party. This is nothing new, certainly.
Nothing new, but you said change, no? You are the same, accept that, no? Let us decide. Why are you not letting us decide? You should not talk. You are urban Naxal. I am talking to people. We are asking you a question. Why are you asking a question back? Why are you talking?
So, in principle, you don't agree with the wealth redistribution idea. You think it is more in the realm of ideas than actual implementation.
The concept which Narendra Modi or you people have understood it, no? That nobody can do it. You have not understood the spirit of that. You have misread the expression.
I mean, what was exactly said was that we will do the socio-economic.
It is your opinion.
Not an opinion.
Exactly,
I am
my opinion.
I am quoting what Mr. Gandhi
said. I am interested in that.
But
we
are
asking you basic, genuine questions.
I can only understand what is told to me. If Mr. Gandhi is saying,
where are the jobs?
Okay, all legitimate questions.
What happened to the farmers? What is happening?
All legitimate questions.
What is happening in Ladakh? What is happening in Ladakh? You promised. You promised you will give statehood to Ladakh. You promised in the last manifesto that you will give 2 MPs. What are you doing now? You will put 144 section. If they protest, if they remind you, if they say we are going to see the border and see how much of China has taken, you will put 144. For the next 2 months, where Ladakh, only this tourism is their bread and bunny, you'll make them foodless. This autocracy, this arrogance doesn't work.
When you take,
let us decide. This is our argument. As the people of this country, we are going to question, revisit all his promises. Let us take a decision.
To play the devil's advocate, these were pretty much the arguments you had made in 2019 also. And at that time when you had contested from Bengaluru Central, you had said, I want to be the voice of change. But the people did not reciprocate. You got less than 4%.
It is okay.
Why do you think people will buy this argument now? That they won't buy into what the BJP is saying, that genuine work has happened.
The point is whether buy or not. My integrity is strong. I will continue to do it. In this country, victory and failure is of not individuals. If you choose right, it is people's victory. If you choose wrong, it is people's failure. Now I will continue the discussion because the people of this constituency know. I had promised you elect me, I will be your voice. If I don't, you elect me also, I will be your voice. I have worked here. I've adopted villages, I've adopted schools, I've given ambulances, I've worked during COVID. And I'm here also saying, this time, guys, I've come here not to ask your vote, but let us discuss. Was our vote right?
But if today any of these...
to vote again. Let's decide. Think for some time, have a conversation before we vote. Simple.
But if any of these people were to come to you and say, vote for who? Who, which party will you tell them to vote?
That they should decide. They should question both the parties, any political party, what they promised, what they delivered. You decide. You have a feel. I should not say don't vote for him. I should not say that. I have to have a conversation. We have to have a discussion. We have to understand, remember, remind ourselves, and then do. Because we may also make mistakes. We might have been brainwashed to vote somebody. But have you realized is what I want to know. Why shouldn't I do that?
Do you think that the state government in Karnataka is doing a job that you approve of?
Karnataka state government?
Yeah.
Did I choose the government?
I mean, I'm assuming that you are a voter here and you would have chosen somebody.
You will assume anything. Do you see me with any of this Karnataka Congress?
Do they measure up to your ideals of good governance?
Did you see me? Did you see me standing with any of these political leaders in the last 5 years?
As a voter, are they measuring up to your expectations?
I think they are more secular. This state has become more secular because of Siddaramaiah. I am not talking about a party. We have a local leader who is not a national leader. And our local leader is more popular than your national leader in this state because he has been through his life talking about secularism. He has behaved as a secular chief minister and he has brought in rules as a secular chief minister. We are safe with him. Yeah. But this is a national election. So we need to think. We are not electing a state government. We are clear about that too. So we are having a discussion. Is a national party which had promised, are they worth it or not? It's a discussion I would like to have with all my chalams.